Hello, fun people. I'm Isaac Carlson, and today we're going to be discussing Mad at Disney, a popular song that blew up on TikTok by Salem Illies. And it's something that I want to discuss today because while Salem finds the stories told by Disney to be very problematic, as someone who's a big Disney fan, I feel like I want to provide my own reaction and thoughts around the issues that she brings up. Where do I think that Disney fits into the world through their stories in the modern age? So the song begins by saying, "I'm mad at Disney, Disney. They tricked me, had me wishing on a shooting star. But now I'm 20-something, I still know nothing about who I am or what I'm not." I still think the song is super catchy, even though I might not agree with every idea that's brought forward. I think it's really important that we all analyze the content and the media that we consume, whether that be advertisements, rom-coms, or Disney movies. So I think this is a great way to be able to begin a discussion about Disney's place in culture. And for me, I see Disney as a company that has become iconic and synonymous with the idea of pursuing dreams. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I think the idea of going after something that you really want to have in your life is something that's valuable. Because what is the alternative? You can be pessimistic about it and continue to move forward, but I just think the idea of having optimism and being driven to continue to move forward in whatever you'd like is something that is important. Everything should be able to be pursued as long as you're doing it with the right intent. I don't think there's anything wrong with doing something for yourself, and I think you should absolutely go after love. Now, the thing for me in this section of the song is the idea of being tricked. It feels like Disney is trying to build up and be manipulative in their practices of telling stories, which I don't really think is the case. From everything I understand about Disney, Disney is putting forth an idealistic version of the world through their classic fairy tale stories. And so I don't think it's something where Disney is trying to push forward a reality that is something that can never exist to try to make people long for their products more or long to feed into their stories and their merchandise. I think Disney is telling stories that are trying to be the most hopeful and optimistic and passionate about what a future could look like. I think Disney is good at blending the idealism and possibly glorifying in the process certain aspects of life, but at the same time, I think that they're not trying to do it in a malicious way. So by putting forward the idea that they tricked you, I feel like there's something missing there. There's not the perspective of the people that are creating it or what the intent actually is. And so I feel like if you're being tricked, then you're taking certain elements from the stories and only internalizing certain aspects. And then she goes on to say, "So call me a pessimist, but I don't believe in it. Finding a true love's kiss is bull." So I think it's interesting that she kind of acknowledges in this song that her perspective now as a 20-something is now in a more pessimistic frame of mind. And I think that's just kind of the differing ways of looking at the world, is that Disney is very consistently optimistic and positive and pushing forward the idea of magic, even though the world is more complicated than the worlds that they create or that you experience through their theme parks. But I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. I feel like the worlds that are depicted in Disney and the stories that are told are ways to show that adversity can be triumphed over. Salem continues to say, "'Cause I felt sad love, I felt bad love, sometimes happy love turns into giving up, I felt hurt love by the word love. What is love supposed to feel like? What is love?" So what this indicates to me is that the pessimism and the feeling of being tricked comes from the idea that she was hurt in the past, that there was experiences throughout her life thus far into her early 20s where love hasn't worked out as well as she believed that it would from Disney films. For me, though, it doesn't really make sense that watching the Disney canon would give you an adequate depiction of what love is necessarily supposed to be. I think if you take your perception of love from a source that's from outside of yourself, there's always going to be a disconnect and flaws between those two perspectives. I also feel like in Disney movies recently, there's been a trend of overly simplifying the stories that are being told in a way that makes the stories feel more problematic than they actually are. For example, the idea of Ariel not being a character that's active in her life and is making decisions for herself feels very wild to me, because before she even was aware of her prince, she was internalizing that she desires to go and experience the human world. It's really just when she discovers this prince that that's the tipping point, that she already had these dreams, and then she went through and made decisions, made mistakes to attempt to achieve those dreams. She had to overcome these difficulties in her life, dealing with her father not understanding her, trying to break her curse, and eventually needing to break up the fake wedding that was taking place. Ariel has to be involved in a lot of aspects of her story, but often the idea that she's fighting for love at all diminishes her, and the idea that she ends up in a happy marriage at the end feels something that's unrealistic, which I disagree with. Throughout other stories like Aladdin and Beauty and the Beast, characters are in situations where they are dealing with adversity and then have to overcome them, whether that be the strict laws and the evil Jafar, or whether that be being forced to grow up in a small town where you don't have opportunities to break off of the world and experience life. A lot of Disney, even though it's about love and finding love, I don't think necessarily pushes forward the idea that once you find someone that you want to be with, that love comes extremely easily. A lot of Disney tells stories about love overcoming physical adversities, even though the reality is a lot of it is coming over emotional and relationship adversities. Getting through those barriers is important regardless of which one you're going through. But both of them are legitimate forces that have to be broken through. And I don't think Disney necessarily pushes forward the idea that you suddenly get love just for being beautiful. Now, there's some even more simplified stories like Sleeping Beauty, where the main protagonist really isn't the purpose of the story, that it's really this simplified story tale that's meant to be an artistic depiction and have simplified tropes coming together to form an interesting story. But even look at Snow White and Cinderella. Cinderella had to deal with the abuse of her stepmother and her sisters until she finally got the opportunity to be able to break off of the world and be able to marry into a family and find true love and be able to break out of her home. And Snow White is the same thing, that she had it evil stepmother hold her within the castle, treat her like a servant until she was able to align with people that were able to work with her so that she could thrive and survive outside of that evil woman. I can understand where you're coming from. Everyone experiences heartbreak and everyone experiences dark relationships and goes through rough times and has those difficult relationship traumas. And in reality, going through those hardships means that you're actually moving towards discovering what you want out of a relationship. Statistically speaking, those who get married after 30 are far less likely to get divorced. And on average, people have 7 serious relationships before they get married. So what does that indicate? People's brains don't stop developing until 25, which means that you need to have a mature mind. You need to, and through the 7 relationships idea, you need to have experience and maturity and have an understanding of what you want out of a relationship. So going through hardships is a good thing in the pursuit of true love. The adversities that you go through aren't necessarily a bad thing. They're just elements that are important to experience so that you can move towards the true love that you actually want to experience, which is exactly what Disney shows through physical threats in their films. Salem goes on to say, "My fairy grandma warned me Cinderella's story only ended in a bad divorce. The prince ain't sleeping when he takes his Sleeping Beauty to the motel on his Snow White horse." Now that verse I just think is hilarious. This song is very catchy, and with these little jabs and jokes, I think are really funny, but I don't necessarily continue to agree with the ideology that's being pushed in the song. The idea that after the story is done in a Disney movie, that the characters go on to experience more relationship issues, I think is something that is real, but at the same time, it's not supposed to be a horrible world. And sure, your life doesn't stop being difficult just because you found a partner to live your life with. But I also think it just stinks to think that characters that seem to have this magnetic relationship and instantaneous love for one another would be able to degrade. And of course, that can happen at times. But again, it's the importance of being able to recognize relationships that are toxic or more infatuation than actual love and commitment, and finding that out is important before you get to that really dark place. Of course, if you actually go the Disney route and you quickly get married few days after you actually meet, yeah, I think it could make sense that you might not know enough about the person to be able to make an informed decision. I will admit that. I would not recommend that either. But it's the idea of if you make the commitment to someone and you believe you have a good relationship and it's able to actually support both people and, you know, push you both forward in a positive way, I don't necessarily think that divorce is something that's inevitable. Because people are getting married when they're older, divorce rates are actually decreasing over time. People are actually on a trend of going and experiencing relationships before they commit to marriage. And that's an important thing. And also the idea of people being unfaithful. I mean, that's a difficult thing to deal with. I can't imagine it. It's a horrible thing I never would want to put someone through. And that's just another horrible thing to experience. But again, here's the thing though. If someone is going to treat you like that, that's not someone you want to be with. So it's a clear indication of what you need to do in your own life. They don't actually want to be with you because they're with someone else. The song goes on to repeat its chorus, and then in the outro says, "I'm mad at Disney, Disney. They tricked me. No more wishing on a shooting star." I think it makes a lot of sense based off of the title of the song and what's being discussed, but I feel like it's a sad reality that I don't want people to actually experience. The idea that you should give up on any element of your ideal future is really sad, and I don't think people internalize how much time they have to be able to figure things out like this. The idea that I truly am disagreeing with is the idea that the response to the belief of true love not being a pure existence and not being something that's as easy to attain as in a Disney movie, even though I would argue that there are lots of depictions of adversity to achieve love in Disney films, I don't think the proper response is to determine that love is not something that should be pursued. I think that there should be an element of optimism and wish fulfillment and hope that goes into pursuing love. And I don't think there's anything inherently wrong with that. I think the issue is that if you reduce films and the media that you're consuming to one simplified element without fully examining the context and the story that's being told, then you can get depictions of love that are overly simplified. And if you base your entire future off of that, then you can be disappointed. I also just wanted to articulate as well that if there is going to be something that we should be mad at Disney for, I think there's a lot of things to be critical of. The concept of them overusing intellectual property and pushing forward this uncreative future and damaging their reputation. Disney working with China when there's human rights issues going on across the country. And the reality that 28,000 1,000 cast members recently got laid off from the company. Now, I'm not trying to say that since there's other issues going on at the Walt Disney Company that we can't be critical of how Disney portrays the human experience in their movies or TV shows or theme parks. For me, this is just not something that I'm frustrated with Disney with at the time. But you know, that's also coming from a perspective of someone who really loves Disney and enjoys their ideology about idealizing the world and trying to find optimism and opportunity where it exists. From what I understand, choosing a partner in your life is one of the most important decisions that you'll ever make. So I don't think that a single source, a single company can be blamed for misconceptions about how love is meant to be worked through. There's so many different sources that can be influencing you, and I don't think one that's pushing forward an idea of optimism and that true love will be able to persevere over all is necessarily a bad thing to put out into the world. I think that there just has to be an understanding that while the pursuit of true love is noble, that we also have to be responsible on ourselves and allow ourselves time to be able to mature, develop, and become whole individuals before we commit ourselves to another individual or decide that another individual is perfect for us. Believing that it's easy to find someone who fits you perfectly and makes you happy for long into your life and is someone who you're able to continue to work with and be a team with, if that is something that you believe is something that's easy to obtain, that's a naive belief. Relationships are very difficult, but are very rewarding. If you're hoping that someone is going to just appear in your life spontaneously and they're going to be able to achieve everything that you desire from them without you communicating or being there or being present or putting in the work, then of course, true love is something that's going to be very difficult to attain. And really, the idea of true love in general is something that I feel like is built instead of something that is discovered. You can have lots of chemical romance with someone immediately, but it's only through that grit and grind of being in a relationship week after week are you able to actually build something that's meaningful. I really don't want people my age or younger to feel discouraged if they haven't found someone that they have been able to connect with or fall in love with yet. The reality is that statistically speaking, you'll be able to live for decades into the future, and there's the opportunity for so many of those years to be able to learn how to meet people and how to connect with people and to build relationships and find relationships and partners that actually are able to benefit your life and to make you happy. And so I think there's absolutely the possibility of being able to find love. And I think you just have to be able to put in the work and overcome the adversity, whatever form they take, to be able to actually achieve that. But those are just my ideas. What have you thought of Mad at Disney? Is it stuck in your head? Do you really enjoy it? Let me know. I'm super excited to hear your perspective on it. Also, make sure to subscribe and click the beautiful bell, and then click on another magical video in the description or on the screen. Finally, thank you to my patrons. Thanks for watching, and have a magical day.